Very good morning, friends. This is Balaji. So in this topology, we are going to see how to redistribute from ERGRP to OSPF, OSPF to ERGRP. Let assume company A running as a ERGRP routing protocol and company B running as OSPF routing protocol. So both company want to communicate with each other. Okay. So for that scenario, we have so many option is there. So here in this videos, we are going to see how to redistribute from different routing protocol. Okay. So before going that, I will show you some. So already configuration is done about one internal one. Just I make sure whether the communication is established from the internal one. So I'm going to ping any one of the IP. Let's take already have texted for 30.2.2. I will show you that video. So the communication is happening. Okay. So I'm just for ensuring I'm going to just do for testing purpose. I'm going to ping this IP address of the ERGRP routing protocol. Like in the sense, so destination host unreachable. In the sense that there is no way how the traffic should be goes. In the sense that is the reason for destination host unreachable. So we will fix the issue for this one. So we can ping any one of the IP. So let us assume we can ping 40.0.0.2. Okay, for confirmation, we are getting reply. Nice. So we are ensuring the ERGRP, OSPF IP address 192.168.2.20. So destination host unreachable. Okay. So then any one of the router, we are seeing the IP routes. See, we are seeing only OSPF, then directly connected interface, right? So here we can see. So D in the sense, obviously ERGRP, then L means local interface, C connected. So we are not seeing the other network. In the sense OSPF network, we are not seeing the ERGRP network. Right, so I'm going to redistribute now. So in this router, I have configured OSPF and ERGRP because both routing protocols should be communicated, right? So in this router only, router 7, in the sense router 7 only, I will change it for host name. So make sure, so running config. You could see I'm running, means I have configured ERGRP and OSPF in this router 7, because both company want to communicate, right? Both company having different routing protocol. So router 7 would be the helping us to redistribute the both routing protocol, right? So in this router only we have to configure both routing protocol, but rest of the router not required. For your information, I will show you. So running config, see here I have configured only the OSPF, here I have configured only ERGRP. Okay, you got it right now. So in this router, I have configured both routing protocol as a usual command, like router ERGRP, blah blah blah. So now I'm explaining how to redistribute the command. Config T. So now I'm going to redistribute OSPF OSPF topology to the ERGRP. Okay. So how I'm going to do? Simple. So OSPF, right? So router OSPF, then process ID. So all router I have configured process ID of 1 and area would be 0. Okay, same I'm using. So process ID is 1, then redistribution EHRP, then if you give question mark it will come matrix, then subnet, etc. I'm sorry, then autonomous system ID. So I used EHRP as well as the same one as the autonomous system ID. If I give question mark it will come matrix, matrix type, subnet. Less this video I'm going to explain how to redistribute from subnet, so I'm giving the subnet. So here how clear in this OSPF I have redistribute all EHRP routing protocol. So here I'm going to show you. So here we can see only OSPF, right? If I'm going to rerun that command, you can see EHRP topology, in the sense EHRP subnet as well. Here see E1 is nothing, one external one and external two. I will explain later about what is different between external one and external two in this separate video, but here we can look. Now we can see all EHRP subnet, it came to the OSPF router, so like 172.172.172, etc. So we are ensured, right? So now I'm going to redistribute EHRP to OSPF because the first part is completed and second part is now it's same simple. Router, so EHRP to OSPF, right? So we have to give router EHRP, then process ID have used 1, so same use 1, then redistribution OSPF, I think area ID will ask, sorry, process ID, so same process ID I have used for everyone. Now it will be ask bandwidth, delay, reliability, MTU. For your reference I will show you. See, now it's coming. I'm sorry, before that we can see the metrics. So there we have used metrics, right? Instead of metric we have used subnet, but in OSPF we can see metrics and matches, so we are using metrics. After metrics we can see reliability, bandwidth, etc. So first it will ask the bandwidth. So what bandwidth we have to give, it's pretty easy, so simple. So router 7 and EHRP, it's connected with the serial cable, right? So what is the bandwidth we can give? So if you have confusion, go to this router and see what is the bandwidth for serial 0/0, because both bandwidth would be the same for both router, in the sense both is the same cable, right? So I'm going to see. So interface serial 0/0/0. See friends. So MTU is 1500, bandwidth is 5400 kilobytes, delay is 2000, then reliability is 255 TX load and RX load. So here they are used 1500, right? So this is router 3. We'll go for router 7. Okay. So what is the matrix? Matrix after that bandwidth. So bandwidth here used is 1500. We can give 1500, no issues. Then delay is 2000 use, so we can divide it by 10, what value will become 200. So 200 we can give. Before that, for your information I will do question mark. So see delay, so delay here 2000, so divided by 200. Okay, now it will come with the reliability for your information. So it asking reliability, right? What is the reliability? 255. After it will become the TX load for your information. See load, right? So what load there currently is 1. Okay, then next if you give question mark it will come MTU. See MTU, what is the MTU is there? 1500. So clear, right? So I'm giving the redistribution now. So router 7 redistribution is done. So earlier we have see the topology, right? Here we can see only D in the sense EHRP and connection, means connected one and local one. We are not able to see the OSPF routing table and OSPF net subnet, right? I'm running the recommand and you could see the OSPF here. See, in the sense external EHRP. There we can see E1 and E2, because E1 and E2 is OSP of external type 1 and external type 2. In this EHRP we can see EX. EX means external EHRP. So we could see all internal subnet and OSP of subnet. I'm sorry. So earlier I hope you remember, right? Earlier we do test for different company IP address of this laptop, right? So earlier the communication is coming as destination host unreachable. Now it will be give the result. You can see. In the sense company B able to communicate company A. Okay. And we can confirm with the company A to company B's communication is there or not. So already we done. So we can see. Clear, right? So both company now able to communicate with each other, like company A to company B and company B to company A with different routing protocol. I hope this you are enjoying this video, and this is very useful information for you. If you have any question, please give the comment.